it breaks my heart that there's nothing here to even let anybody know that he was even ever here.
An empty space leaving unanswered questions for Janie Seagraves.
I know that there's probably technically nothing left, but there is something left. It's a memory that's left.
A headstone served as a memory of her older brother, Ernest Watkins Jr. He was just 2 years old when he died of cancer and was buried here.
I want to know what happened to my brother's remains.
Jane visited the cemetery a month ago.
My grandfather was buried over here in 1926. My grandmother was buried out here in the 1950s.
She says she couldn't believe her brother's headstone was no longer there. This is a picture of what it looks like.
Where do you believe the marker was once?
In this area right here.
John Sweeper takes care of the property. He purchased the cemetery from the city of Greensboro back in 2010 to bring it back to life.
So I got together with a lot of my friends and buddies and started cleaning it up. Head mark was everywhere.
Sweeper says he advertised for people who had loved ones in the cemetery to claim their headstones over a 3-year period.
Before we put the fence up, we would contact the city and ask the city, what about these markers here? He said, it's up to you what you want to do. So I take all the markers up and move it in the back in one row.
There are still some headstones on the property that need to be identified.
I can't read the name.
Sweeper told me he does not know where Seagraves' headstone is, but that she has the option to buy another one.
We don't have no reason to move a head marker. We install head markers. We want everybody to have a head marker. And the old one is here. We continue to maintain it. We want it to be here. But what she's talking about, it was here, but she'd never come out and try to find out what's what. So we don't know.
I don't know if anybody else is in this same situation from this particular cemetery, but taking up the markers and crushing them and stuff never made any sense to me.